Hey there, it's Sarah Bailey. Today I want to talk to you about what to do when people say no to you about your network marketing business or your home business. Coming to you from my hotel room, I'm at a conference right now, learning new strategies about helping people achieve incomes they want through entrepreneurship. And it's a really fabulous conference, and I'm losing my voice, but it's the way that it goes. Okay, so here's something that happens with people in network marketing when people say no to them in their business, and it's giving us a bad reputation in general. Okay, so I want to help change the image in network marketing, and that can be helped a little bit with a couple of these strategies. Okay, so when people say no to you about your business, number one, don't be weird. Okay, number two, don't be clingy, and three, don't chase people. Okay, it looks really bad. So over the course of your network marketing career, you're going to talk to hundreds and hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of people. So any one person who says no to you is not that big of a deal. They're not going to make or break your business. So move on. The big message here is just to get on with it and go talk to somebody else. If somebody says no, find somebody else, okay? But if somebody says no to you and they've been somewhat receptive to what you're teaching them or what you're showing them with your business plan, they kind of like it, but they say it's not for them. Two things you can do. One is to say, all right, no problem. It sounds like the timing is not right for you. Would it be all right with you if I stayed in touch with you every few weeks and gave you updates as we grow the business? And they're probably going to say yes. The other thing you could do is four words that you should remember, okay? Who do you know? Okay, you're going to ask for the referral. Who do you know who might be looking for extra ways to earn money right now? Who do you know who's looking to earn an extra couple thousand dollars a month? Okay, so you go for the referral. Now, here's an analogy that may help you with the whole chasing people thing, okay? And that is, let's say you go to a movie and it's a really good movie. You love it, okay? You tell somebody about it and then they go see it. So they see the movie and then after they come out of the movie, you say, "Wasn't that a great movie?" And they say, "Yes." Now, do you keep going on and on and on about the movie? Like, "Wasn't this part great and that part great and this part?" And you just go on and on. You're gonna like nauseate them. So you just don't do that. You just don't keep talking about the movie over and over again. So if somebody says no to your business, stop chasing them. You may see that it's a great opportunity. You may see that it's a great benefit to them. You can see what it will do for your family to create financial freedom for you or for time freedom, whatever it is. But the people you're talking to may not get it yet, okay? But the best thing to do is just to back off and move on. Go ahead and build your business. Let them watch you build your business. All right? So the thing is just to move on. Now, if you're showing your business opportunity through a video, and then you were to call the person after they watch the video for a follow-up. Let's say they're a no-show on the follow-up. Okay, leave one message, maybe two messages, but drop it then. Okay, just leave it alone. So, what do you say in the message? You call somebody up at the scheduled time and you say, "Hey John, this is Sarah calling you back. We have a scheduled time to talk right now. It's 2 o'clock on Wednesday. And I'm not sure if you got through the video or not yet, but I wanted to be able to answer any questions you may have about it. And our time was scheduled. I wrote it down in my calendar. And I don't think you would miss the appointment intentionally. So I hope everything's okay. When you get this message, give me a call back either today or tomorrow. I look forward to hearing from you." So that's it. Leave it alone. Let's say a couple days go by and he still hasn't called you back. You can call him again and say, "Hey John, this is Sarah. Just want to check back with you. I called you a couple days ago and have not heard back from you. So that means you're probably either not interested in the business or life got busy for you. Whichever it is, you can call me back and let me know. If you're not open to the business, it's okay. It's no big deal. We're still friends. It's okay, you know." And then you just move on, okay? But you can also say in the message, "Listen, John, I want to let you know I do not chase people. So if you're serious about earning that $2,000 a month you said you wanted to earn, then give me a call back by the end of the day today or by the end of the day tomorrow. I will not continue to call you and, you know, ask you about this business. Either you're open to it or you're not, and that's perfectly fine." And then you drop it, okay? If you see John out and about around town, you just move on with your life, okay? It's like the movie's over, right? You're not going to keep talking about the movie over and over again. So you just drop it. You talk about family, kids. If you're friends on Facebook, you can post comments on the wall. You can stay in touch that way, but just move on, okay? It's when you think about it all the time and you want to bring it up all the time that people will think that you're being weird, and you don't want to be weird. You just want to be normal, okay? One of the best ways to not be clingy with people is to have more people to talk to in a day than time in a day to get to all of them. Okay, so if you have so many people you have to get to, you're not going to worry about the people who are saying no. So I hope this has been helpful. I'd love to hear your feedback. Post your comments below, share the video, go to my blog. This will show up both on YouTube at Sarah Bailey Marketing, or it may show up on my blog as well, and that's at sarahdbailey.com. So I'd love to hear from you. Hope you have a fantastic day. Here's to your success.